What's up, you guys? Welcome to Up and Above. In today's video, I'm gonna show you, yes, you, my friend, how to install a GFCI from start to finish. The cover, the ground tail, the right way to splice, and the right thing to do. Remember to subscribe to the channel and be part of the community as we continue to grow. Enjoy this video, learn something, do things the right way. I see you at the end. All right, you guys, let's dive in. So as I just finished with my switches, now we're gonna dive into the GFCI. So one of the first thing you wanna do before you install your GFCI outlet is you wanna take the ground tail that is in the box and the ground tail that is going to the panel. And then you wanna take an additional one, a third one, and you splice all three together using alignment. Some of you might know it as a pair of pliers. So you take all three together, you twist them a few times. Once you finish doing that, you cut the edge. You definitely gotta cut the edge, as you can see I'm about to do. And then you give it one final twist. Once you've done that, the next thing you wanna do, you wanna grab your wire nut. So the wire nut is what's gonna keep it together and safe inside a box. You don't just wanna splice your ground tail and then push it in the box. That is not the proper practice. So once you do that, you wanna tuck it in nice and neat inside in the corner. So the next thing you're gonna do, you're gonna strip your ground tail, have it ready. And then you're gonna strip your neutral, have it ready. And then you're gonna strip your hot leg, which is the black one, and have it ready. As you can see, I'm getting everything ready. So in my case, in case you're wondering, I'm not working live. So if you don't have to work live, please don't work live. It's better to work when the power is off. It's safer that way. You live to see another day. Electricity is a dangerous thing. So this is my GFCI. So don't come at me. I'm one to like to put WR weather resistant GFCI in bathrooms. I don't like to put the regular one. I like to put the outdoor GFI in the interior bathroom. That's just what I like to do. That's just my preference. You don't have to do it. It's not code. If you use a regular GFCI, you still could do that. As you can see, I'm tucking in my neutral. And then I'm gonna make sure it's tight. You don't wanna over tighten it. You wanna do it just enough. And the next thing I'm gonna do is the black one. So once I finish the black one, then I'm gonna grab my Phillips screwdriver and I'm gonna tighten it. The next key element you wanna do after that, you definitely wanna grab electrical tape. You go around it 1 to 2 times to keep everything safe. Funny enough, it's not in the code book to put tape around your electrical outlet devices, but if you're a real electrician, a real one, you do that. So this go back to what I was saying earlier. As you could see that I'm not forcing myself to push the GFI inside the box. It's going nice and neat because I have already prepped the wire behind the GFCI. When I splice my wire nut, I make everything to the side so everything is ready to go. So in my case, you're gonna notice I'm not gonna screw my GFI all the way. There's one reason why. I'm using a screwless cover. So a screwless cover, basically, it's a nicer look. You don't see the screw after you finish install the cover. Everything is hidden behind. So the reason I didn't screw my outlet all the way in, I want to put in the screwless part one face plate first. Once I finish do that, then I'm gonna grab my level while I'm screwing it in so everything could be level at one time. So once I put my level, everything is good to go. So the next thing I'm gonna do is tighten it some more to go in the wall. So once I finish do that, then I'm gonna grab part two of the faceplate and then clip it in. It is very important to know that when you put in your faceplate, you wanna follow the instruction. As you can see, mine has the arrow facing up. Some doesn't, but some does. This one says stop. You wanna make sure that goes to the top and this piece goes in the bottom. So as you can see, you push it in and clip everything. And then that's it. That's pretty much it, guys. Thank you for tuning in, for watching my video. I hope you subscribe to the channel and be part of the community as we continue to grow. Remember to subscribe. Stay blessed. I'm out. Peace. Till next time.